Okay, now let's move on to the Sutram Striyam Kthin, which is 3394. Adhikara of Striyam goes from this sutram all the way down to 3312, which is Akroshe Nayanihi. So up to that point, this Anuvritti of Striyam goes down. Also, let's not forget that the Adhikara of Bhave, as well as Akartricha, Karake, Sanyayam, runs down from 3318, 3319, all the way down to 3312. So at 3312 ends the Adhikara of Bhave, Akartricha, Karake, Sanyayam, which is coming down from 3318, 19, as well as the Adhikara of Striyam coming down from 3394. All that ends at 3312, which is Akroshe Nayanihi. So this entire Adhikara of Striyam is within the Adhikara of 3318, 19, Bhave and Akartricha Karake Sanyayam. So the Vritti of the Sutram says Strilinge Bhavadav Kthin Syat. Strilinge Bhavadav Kthin Syat, which means that the affix kthin may be used following a verbal root to denote in the feminine gender either bhave, meaning the sense of the verbal root as having attained to a completed state, or akartrich karake sanyayam, which is any karakaha except the agent of the action, provided the word so derived is a proper name. Now one note here is that this affix kthin prescribed by the Sutram 3394 is apavada for the affix ghanya, which is prescribed by 3318, 3319. The affix ghani prescribed by 3318 and 3319 is a general prescription. It did not say any specific gender, so it applies following any verbal root in general, and it did not give any gender restriction. Now this one, kthin, only is when the derived word is used in the feminine gender. So obviously, the domain of this Sutram 3394 is a subdomain of 3318-19. So this is the apavadaha. Apavadaha means that it should operate in a subdomain of the utsargaha, the default general rule. So the affix ghani prescribed by 3318-19 is the general affix. This one operates in the subdomain of that because it's only applicable in the feminine gender. So this affix kthin is apavada, exception to the affix ghanya in the feminine gender. Now, how about the affix ach and up prescribed by 3356 erach and 3359 rudorup respectively? Now, this kthin affix cannot be considered as a apavadaha for either ach or up. To be a apavadaha, it should be in a strict subdomain of the utsargaha. Now, Striyam kthin is prescribed after any verbal root as long as the word derived is used in the feminine gender. The affix ach is only prescribed after a verbal root ending in the ivarnaha. The affix up is prescribed only after a verbal root ending in the rukaraha, dirgha rukaraha, or the uvarnaha. So, the domain of Striyam kthin is not a strict subdomain of either the affix ach prescribed by 3356 or the affix up prescribed by 3357. So in short, Striyam kthin is not a apavadaha for either of those. But Striyam kthin is a parakaryam. It is a later rule in the Ashtadhyayi compared to either 3356 erach or 3357 rudorap. So therefore, in cases where both are applicable, for example, take the dhatu chi, chi chayane from the swadiganaha. Now, if you want to express bhavaha in the feminine gender, then what happens? Can we use the affix ach by erach because the verbal root chi ends in the ivaranaha? And the answer is no, because Striyam kthin is a parakaram. It is a later rule in the Ashtadhyayi. So, we have to use the affix kthin and get the form chitihi. We cannot get chaya in the feminine gender. Similarly, if it is a verbal root stu, now here rudorap is also applicable because stu ends in the uvarnaha. But in the feminine gender, only Striyam kthin should be used because it's a parakaryam. It's a later rule in the Ashtadhyayi. Hence, we get the form stutihi. We cannot use the form stava in the feminine gender. So bottom line is that in the feminine gender, the affix kthin overrules ach prescribed by 3356 here ach and up prescribed by 3357 rud or up, because 3394 is a later rule in Ashtadhyayi compared to those two rules. Okay, one more point here is that this affix kthin cannot take the augment it regardless of the verbal root to which it is applied because of the sutram 7.2 which we have studied. Ti, tu, tra, ta, tha, si, su, sa, ra, ka, se, shu, cha. Padini has listed a number of affixes which are prohibited from taking the augment it, and this affix ti, which includes kthin and kthich, is mentioned in that sutram. So therefore, one good news is that when we apply this affix kthin, we don't have to look at the verbal root. This affix kthin does not take the id augment. Just take one example here. Karanam kritihi. So this is bhave. Karanam is the act of doing, an action. So kritihi is a feminine form. This is derived, of course, from the verbal root kru, which is dikring karne. This is well known to us. It's from the tanadi ganaha. So here, where the intention is to derive a feminine word denoting bhavaha, which means the sense of the verbal root as having attained to a completed state. So kritihi is an action. So we take the verbal root kru, add the affix kthin by this sutram 3394, striyam kthin. It is apavadaha for the affix ghani, which would have come in by 3318. And remove these letters kakaras itsanya by dashakvatadhyate, nakaras itsanya bahalantyam tasya lopaha. Now, the nakaraha in kthin is only for the purpose of intonation, swarartha. It's only applicable in the Vedaha. In the classical language, there is no intonation, there is no swaraha. So it has no implication for us here. The kakaras in it does have implication, of course, because here 115, kniticha, stops the gunadesha, which would have been done by 7384, sarvadhatakardhatakayoho. So the rukaraha of the angam kru is prevented from taking the gunadesha because of kniticha 115, because the affix kthin is a kit. Not only that, we see other examples where the kakara is a it performs other functions. For example, if we take the verbal root gum, we get the form gati. There what happens is that we use 6437. So again there, the affix kthin being kit is important because we can apply 6437 when we take gum plus ti and make it gati. Anunasika lopaha is done by 6437. Similarly, if we take the dhatu vach, we get the form ukti. Ukti, we get samprasaranam because 6115 vachi swapi yajadi naam kiti, that sutram, as well as the following sutram 6116, they apply in the case of this affix kthin because it is a kit. The effects of the kakaras and it we have many times before, so all those have to be kept in mind when it comes to this affix kthin. Okay, so kriti gets the pradipadika sanya by krit, dita samasascha, and this is used in the feminine gender only because this affix kthin only comes in when the derived word is to be used in the feminine gender. So very, very popular affix, common affix to use a lot in the language. For example, in the Bhagavad Gita, very last line of the Gita, yatra yogeshwaraha krishno yatra partho dhanurdharaha yatra shreer vijayo bhutir dhruva nitir matir mama. So you have bhutihi, nitihi, matihi, three words ending the affix kthin in one line itself of the Gita. So it's a very common affix. We'll be seeing many, many examples of this sutram. And also remember that the adhikara of striyam is going to run down from here up to 33112.